I very frequently hear from quilters who see this kind of thing, either at a quilt shop or a friend who's sewing with a running stitch or one of my other videos on the website, and they'll say, "Oh my goodness, that is so much faster, but I started my quilt with English paper piecing. I wish I had known before that I could sew these designs with a running stitch." So they're actually on the website. There's been something called English Paper Piecing Rescue. It's a very popular page on the site, and it tells you how you can take something like this that I sewed with English paper piecing. It took longer to, cut the templates and baste everything than it would have just to sew the thing for real. But I did this so that I would have a little sample. Then all you have to do is remove the template. So you have to take out the stitches. And usually you can then start stitching. Here, I'll go to this other camera again. This camera here. This one. You can see if I take out the template from this one, I had to remove the red stitching basting, and normally I can then just sew by following the crease. That is enough for me to be able to see, especially if I sew with the printed Inklingo hexagon up facing me. Just following the crease on the other side is enough. And here I've put this in. Now, for English paper piecing, often quilters use a much wider seam allowance, so you can trim that down. I trimmed it on this one, I didn't on this one. But then you can see I can start pressing the seam allowances to the side. I can press that seam allowance going around so that I get a nice flat intersection and a perfect intersection. If you are interested in switching from English paper piecing to sewing with a running stitch, this is very simple to do, and I know a lot of quilters have done it, but there are detailed instructions under the hand piecing tab on the website if you're looking for some other little clues on that.